In the previous video, we have discussed cyanide poisoning. Today, let's talk about how to diagnose and how to treat this evil poison. Remember, the most common cause in the United States are fires. So firefighters, any person who was involved in the fire. And don't forget, they tried poisoning Rasputin by giving him cyanide. And these are just a couple of my previous videos, so make sure to subscribe. As you know from the previous lecture, cyanide could be gas, liquid, or solid. Cyanide poisoning could be due to inhalation, ingestion, or skin absorption. Causes of cyanide poisoning: smoke inhalation is the most common cause in the United States by far. Suicide ingestion, so pharmacists, doctors, nurses, medications such as sodium nitroprusside, industrial exposure, and the polyurethane in the famous foam bubble wrap just that you keep like picking with your fingers. I love it. That's why I'm crazy, because of the cyanide. Cyanide loves binding to ferric. Therefore, cyanide will either bind to ferric in the methemoglobin or will bind to the ferric in the cytochrome C oxidase in your mitochondria. In the absence of methemoglobin, cyanide have no choice but to bind to the ferric in the cytochrome C oxidase. Now, this enzyme is gone, irreversible binding. This is an enzyme inhibition. This complex 4 is now gone. Oxygen cannot act as an electron acceptor. Therefore, we will go to anaerobic glycolysis as a source for our energy, because ATP from the electron transport chain is no longer viable. And as you know, this pathway is not gonna work when you have no methemoglobin. But when you are relatively lucky and you have methemoglobin, it will bind cyanide, forming cyanomethemoglobin. By the liver rhodanase, thanks to sodium thiosulfate, we end up with thiocyanate, which contains cyanide, and it's gonna be excreted in the urine. Go to hell, cyanide, go multiply by yourself. Some people will never get this joke. Cyanide binds ferric in the cytochrome oxidase, which will lead to inhibition of complex 4. What is complex 4? Cytochrome A3. Now, no ATP formation, with mitochondria cannot utilize oxygen. We will shift to anaerobic glycolysis, which will lead to lactic acid, lactic acidosis, metabolic acidosis. What type? High anion gap metabolic acidosis. What's the normal anion gap? It's less than 12. Now, when your tissue cannot use oxygen, the concentration gradient between hemoglobin and tissue is different. So, here is the red blood cell, which contains the famous hemoglobin. And here is your tissue. Normally, your tissue is using lots of oxygen, lots of oxygen, lots of oxygen, which makes the concentration of oxygen on the hemoglobin greater than the concentration of oxygen in the tissue, which will lead to diffusion. Concentration gradient down, the concentration gradient down, the concentration gradient. But now your tissue is not using oxygen, so there is no concentration gradient for oxygen to flow from hemoglobin to the tissue. Oxygen is gonna stay on the hemoglobin from passing to the artery, then to the vein, because there is no oxygen going to the tissue, because your mitochondria cannot utilize oxygen, which destroys the concentration gradient. There is no gradient, there is no flow to the tissue. The venous oxygen content is high as the artery. That's why in cyanide poisoning, PaO2, which is the partial pressure of oxygen in the artery, equals the PVO2, which is the partial pressure of oxygen in the vein. Some words of wisdom. In cyanide poisoning, despite the abundance of oxygen, it cannot be utilized by the mitochondria. That's how it ends up in the vein. Eating lots of apricots and almond is bad for you. Why? They contain amygdalin, which is hydrolyzed into hydrogen cyanide. One apple a day, keep the doctor away. Lots of almonds a day, mitochondria has gone astray. Eating lots of almond will lead to cyanide poisoning. However, in cyanide poisoning, the patient's breath smells like bitter almond. Just fascinating. So, here is our nice firefighter who serves his community. I serve and protect and smell like almond. Now, if your doctor is gonna test your ability to answer the question about cyanide poisoning correctly, they will use one of these scenarios. The firefighter in coma with almond-like breath after a fire. Patient who was prescribed sodium nitroprusside suddenly collapses. He has metabolic acidosis. Why? Because of the lactic acidosis. The factory worker in the metal industry who comes to the ER comatose after an explosion in the mill. A pharmacist who suffers from major depressive disorder presents with confusion, seizure, and loss of consciousness. He tried cyanide. Clinically, we have symptoms and we have signs. What is the difference between symptom and sign? Symptom is what you as a patient complain of. Signs are what I, as a great doctor, discover or observe. So symptoms, weakness, why? There is no ATP. The electron transport chain is gone. Tissue hypoxia, yes, the tissue is not getting enough oxygen. The mitochondria is not utilizing oxygen, so the oxygen is not gonna flow from the hemoglobin to the tissue. Abdominal pain, chest pain, neurological problems such as headache, very important, vertigo, dizziness, seizure, and coma. All of them are the same as in carbon monoxide poisoning. Now signs. Dilated pupils. Diaphoresis, which is excessive sweating. Because we don't say sweating like the normal public. We are sophisticated. We say diaphoresis, which just means sweating. Arrhythmia. Yep. Cardiovascular collapse possible. Decreased heart rate, decreased blood pressure, increased respiratory rate. Yep, shortness of breath. And the important cherry red skin. Why? Because the partial pressure of oxygen in the vein is high. And what gives your blood the bright color, at least the arterial blood, is the oxyhemoglobin. When you have lots of oxyhemoglobin in the vein is gonna look like the artery, bright red. That's why your skin will look cherry red in color, because your veins are more superficial than your arteries. Don't waste your time on crap, and let's go to the lab. Arterial blood gases. Venous blood gases. What we're gonna find? How about the partial pressure of oxygen in the artery? Normal. Partial pressure of vein on the oxygen, higher than normal. Why? Because oxygen is not going to the tissue because we have destroyed the concentration gradient. PaO2 now roughly equals PVO2. Partial pressure of oxygen in the artery, partial pressure of oxygen in the vein. And partial pressure is not the oxygen that's on the hemoglobin, it's the oxygen in the bloodstream. AV oxygen difference is decreased. It's less than 10%. What is AV oxygen difference? It's the difference between oxygen concentration in the artery and in the vein. They are now relatively equalizing. High anion gap metabolic acidosis due to the lactic acidosis. In high anion gap metabolic acidosis, it's a freaking acidosis, so pH is low. What's the normal pH? From 7.35 to 7.45. So the pH in patients with cyanide is going to be less than 7.35. Important. Decreased bicarbonate because it's a freaking metabolic acidosis. Increased anion gap more than 12. Okay, what's the anion gap? It's the positive ions on one end and the negative ions on the other end. And the difference between them is called the anion gap. There is no actual gap. It's a gap in our knowledge. It's a gap in our measurement. Blood labs. We have increased blood lactate level greater than 10. Increased plasma cyanide concentration. The EKG, non-specific findings. Sinus tachycardia being the most common. Carboxy hemoglobin concentration to rule out CO poisoning because both of them are abundant in fires. Methemoglobin level. Why? To monitor therapy. Because we don't want to give the patient too much methemoglobin, because methemoglobin is also bad. You remember, methemoglobin has pros and cons. What are the pros? It can treat cyanide poisoning, but we can't go too far because methemoglobin can kill you. Please, let me remind you of normal physiology, then we will discuss the effect of cyanide on each one of those. You breathe in air, the air has oxygen. The percentage of oxygen as compared to the atmospheric air is called FiO2, normally 21%. Oxygen goes to the lungs. In the alveoli, it's called P big AO2. Then it goes to the arterial blood. It's called P small AO2. Then jumps on the hemoglobin called SAO2. Jumps to the tissue. The tissue needs oxygen for the electron transport chain and it produces carbon dioxide. Goes to the hemoglobin. This is called oxyhemoglobin. This is called carbaminohemoglobin, not carboxy, carbamino. Then it goes to the venous blood, it's PVO2. Then back to the lungs, you exhale carbon dioxide. So what's the effect of cyanide on each one of those? How about the FiO2? It's perfectly normal. Okay, cyanide has no say on that. How about PAO2 in the alveoli? Again, it's normal. How about PaO2? Normal. SaO2? Normal. But how about the partial pressure of oxygen in the vein? It's high. Oxygen content equals hemoglobin concentration plus PaO2 plus SaO2. What's the effect of cyanide on hemoglobin concentration? Normal. Anemia decreases your hemoglobin concentration, but not cyanide poisoning. How about PaO2? Same thing, normal. SaO2, normal. So the oxygen content in cyanide poisoning, normal, believe it or not. And here I'm talking about the arterial oxygen content. But how about the venous oxygen content? It's increased. In cyanide poisoning, FiO2 is normal, PaO2 is normal, PaO2 is normal, SaO2 is normal. PVO2 is increased. Don't ever forget that. Is the cell affected? Yes, indeed, it's affected. The mitochondria cannot utilize oxygen, so oxygen is released from hemoglobin to tissue, but it cannot utilize it. But didn't you say that oxygen is not released? In the beginning, it is released, but then the mitochondria doesn't use it, so the oxygen doesn't flow anymore. But the problem is not from oxygen being able to leave the hemoglobin and going to the tissue. That's why, generally speaking, the cyanide poisoning does not shift the oxygen binding curve. Some words of wisdom from the father of medicine, Hippocrates. I will use my power to help the sick to the best of my ability. I will abstain from harming or wronging any man by it. I have a terrible British accent. Plus, Hippocrates was Greek, he was not British. What am I doing with my life? So let's use our power to help the sick, and let's learn how to manage cyanide poisoning. First, remove the clothes. Why? Because cyanide poisoning can occur by absorption through the skin. And don't waste your time unbuttoning each button with care because the shirt of the patient was expensive. Just get them off. Don't be an SSS, what I call a super sophisticatedly stupid. Then wash the body with soap and water. Do not wait for the stupid labs. If you suspect cyanide, treat it. How to treat cyanide? 100% oxygen. Then we try the hyperbaric oxygen. Then the hyperbaric chamber. Remember your ABCs first. Airway, breathing, circulation. Establish an IV line and continuous EKG monitoring. Give the cyanide antidote. What is the cyanide antidote? The famous triad. Hydroxycobalamin, sodium nitrite, sodium thiosulfate. Let's talk about sodium thiosulfate. Sodium thiosulfate helps the cyanomet hemoglobin, goes to thiocyanate, then become excreted in the urine, go to hell cyanide, go multiply by yourself. Sodium nitrite converts the normal hemoglobin into methemoglobin so that the methemoglobin can combine with cyanide forming cyanomethemoglobin. Then the sodium thiosulfate will kick in, converting them to thiocyanate, which will be excreted in the urine. So here is the famous triad, hydroxycobalamin, sodium thiosulfate, and sodium nitrite. Sodium nitrite converts the hemoglobin into methemoglobin, the ferrous into ferric. Then the methemoglobin will bind cyanide forming cyanomethemoglobin. Liverodinase, sodium thiosulfate, they will form thiocyanate excreted in the urine. Go to hell. Hydroxycobalamin, on the other hand, combines directly with cyanide forming cyanocobalamin. Again, they are excreted in the urine. And that's how the evil cyanide ends up in the urine. Magnificent. Repetition is the mother of pedagogy. Here we have the hemoglobin ferrous. Thanks to sodium nitrite, now we have the methemoglobin, which contains ferric. Cyanide loves ferric. Without the methemoglobin, cyanide will be able to bind the complex 4, the cytochrome AA3 in the electron transport chain, destroying your mitochondria. destroying your cellular respiration. But now, methemoglobin is gonna distract cyanide and take it away, forming cyanomethemoglobin, sparing the mitochondria from the grief. Then cyanomethemoglobin, thanks to sodium thiosulfate, is gonna be converted into thiocyanate. Thiocyanate. How about the methemoglobin? It goes back to the methemoglobin. We can use methylene blue to return it back to hemoglobin later. But now let's get rid of the cyanomethemoglobin. Use sodium thiosulfate. Now we have thiocyanate, go to hell. So we have mentioned two of the triads, sodium nitrite and sodium thiosulfate. How about the third one? Hydroxycobalamin, vitamin B12, guys. Hydroxycobalamin will bind cyanide, forming cyanocobalamin, go to hell. Without this amazing triad, your cellular respiration will be inhibited. You will end up smelling like bitter almond with cherry red skin until you die. For A+ students, while treating acute cyanide poisoning, do not give methylene blue. Why? Because methylene blue will convert the methemoglobin that we currently need back into regular hemoglobin. Okay, so don't do this. Wait until we clear all the cyanide from the system, then you can give methylene blue to convert the methemoglobin back to the great normal hemoglobin. Do not let methemoglobin level rise too much. We don't want to go too far. Yes, methemoglobin is beneficial in treating cyanide poisoning, but using too much methemoglobin will lead to methemoglobinemia, which is also a disease. So everything has to be balanced. Sodium nitroprusside leads to cyanide poisoning, whereas sodium nitrite and sodium thiosulfate treats this poisoning. This is very important, and most students confuse these. Sodium nitroprusside is evil. It leads to cyanide poisoning. Sodium nitrite and sodium thiosulfate, they treat the cyanide poisoning. Sodium nitroprusside and cyanide and sodium nitrate and sodium nitrite all lead to hypotension. That's why men die on Viagra when they are using sodium nitrate. Both Viagra and sodium nitrate will drop the blood pressure, leading to either death or reflex tachycardia, which will also lead to death. In cyanide poisoning, it's difficult to distinguish between retinal arteries and retinal veins under fundoscopic exam, which is a brilliant point. Why? Because the partial pressure of oxygen in the artery equals the partial pressure of oxygen in the vein, and oxygen is what gives the vessel its bright color. That's why normally arteries have bright red blood while veins have dark. But now we can't differentiate between arteries and veins. Both of them are bright. Guys, it can't get better than that. So please join me on patreon.com/medicosis. And thank you so much for watching my videos. Until next time, be safe, stay happy, and study hard. I'll see you in the next video. We have a crazy mnemonic about cyanide poisoning. Until next time.